Hey guys, this is Neetal from buildify.com. Today we introduce Vinod Residence, located in Coimbatore, Tamil Nadu, designed by Murli Architects. Let me give you quick specs. Spread across a plot area of 3,400 square feet, this 5-bedroom house has built-up area of 6,000 square feet. Architects had the task to balance the family's traditional values along with the contemporary interiors. The key design highlight is the parametric brick facade, which stands out and makes the sculpture beautiful. If you want to know the more details, floor plan dimensions and materials, you can log on to our website buildify.com and download the full PDF ebook. Till then, I hope you enjoy the video.
Today's residences are, collection of boxes, strong boxes called rooms, rather than a celebration of human life, where living together in a beautiful spaces, sharing the spaces, like the way the olden day people did. So our interest in this project, Vinod Residence, is to bring back the old values connected to the current lifestyles and take it to the future where all three generations can coexist beautifully with nature. Mr. Vinod is a businessman located in Coimbatore. He travels a lot and he wanted a very spacious house. So they wanted to live in the same space, but maintaining privacy among each of them. The client was also particular about traditional way of living. He's from Kerala, deep part of Kerala, and he is also religious, little religious. He said his house should reflect the same qualities so that others in the family also can follow the similar lifestyle. He also smilingly cautioned, this house should be, even in future when the daughter grows up, it should be contemporary. So we had a challenge of doing it in the traditional way, at the same time making it contemporary and timelessness for the future generation. We identified some interesting material like brick, which is olden material. But we questioned if the brick can be used in a very contemporary manner, can that become a bridge? We studied the earlier houses, olden houses, where the courtyards become the tying elements of all the members. So we thought we will take that also as a design element. So these two things formed a major direction givers for our project. We also felt the five elements of nature should be the guiding principle for making this house. It is an irregular property. So we are also asked to follow Vastu. Luckily, the site faces north and we had a prolongation of northeast, which is good for Vastu. So we left it as it is. All three sites are empty properties. There is a possibility for thieves entering the house. So what we did was created strong boundary walls, tall walls, which will prevent anybody entering. The side we had another house. So we also treated the site as a strong one with a lot of perforations, which will allow airflow. You have to leave 5 feet all around, but we felt the rear side should have more space. So we left it about 7 or 8 feet, which can also accommodate a garden for the elderly parents. So one enters the foyer and the large living room, with a overview of the pool, overview of the front garden, and there is another court in between the living and the dining, with the stepped stones leading them to the dining. We wanted to make the pool as the important feature, and the deck spaces around it form the gathering places for people. So the southeast corner, that's where the kitchen is. So we felt people from kitchen also should view the pool, and similarly the dining will also have a overview of the pool. And since we talked about he being religious, that becomes the puja court. There is a bench also for elderly mother and father to sit and pray. The bedroom for the elders are located in this corner, but we don't want anybody to view directly into the bedroom. So we created an ante space or a lobby for the elderly parents. So the staircase to the upper floor is happening next to the lift. So the entire rear portion is covered with pergolas. So nobody can come through from the rear or from the sides. Since the site is little small, we could not have more greenery in the ground. What we try to do in the mezzanine is, we projected a floating garden into the living. So from living one can see the greenery. The landing of the staircase, we placed a library and a study corner for the daughter. We also felt the people in the house, they can come and give company to the daughter by having a swing here and seat her in this large garden which is happening around the living. We wanted to connect the mezzanine to the ground floor, so created a glass lounge. So anybody can see what's happening in the dining rooms. And the home theater facilities also here. First floor, in the southwest corner, we have provided the master bedroom. So in the master bedroom also, we've created a garden just behind the lift. So as soon as you enter, you have a feel of the garden. And then there's a balcony for them with a perforated wall here using camp jollies. So the daughter gets a very large bedroom with a view towards the front side, which is an open site where a lot of trees are there. We also given a private balcony. We have created a blank wall, but then we have created a cutout. Through the cutout, she can see what's happening in the street without losing her privacy. And in large washroom, we have created the shower area, and behind that is a court. So the toilet is like a special place set in nature. And then there is a bedroom which is located in the open terrace with the tall walls. So somebody, the guest, can use this facility. And similarly, night time, small mini party can happen in front of the room. So we took the brick, which is a traditional material. So this has got the beauty of lot of character. And why not use this raw material in a futuristic manner? So we used parametric techniques and created wonderful patterns, so which cast interesting shadows into the garden. Same with the pergola also has got a lot of interesting patterns. The swimming pool needed a lot of light, so we went for the entire swimming pool area covered with jolly patterns. So casting a lot of interesting patterns on the tall 20-25 feet wall. Similarly, wrapping the open areas with brick, with parametric openings, created a character which is in line with the front facade. But then Mr. Vinod felt brick all over the house won't be appropriate. So the courtyard in the master bedroom will contain beautiful stones done in an artistic manner, giving the solace that he was looking for in the master bedroom. For the interiors, we chose a concept of being minimalistic. So there is a combination of a play of brick on the large gathering spaces, but at the same time having a play of white where there is a lot of involved activity like kitchen. And when we were wrapping the brick on the facade, so we introduced strong metal grills. We brought in this perforated brick so that it made us very lightweight feel, and the rods could go through in between. On the front lobby side, we created again series of bricks here with a rod, and the rod again onto the wall, so making a beautiful brick pavilion, preventing rainwater hitting the main door. We wanted some material which will kind of age like the way the brick was aging. So all the gates, all were made with cotton steel. brick and the wood goes very well. So the entire staircases were made with wooden planks, and even the daughter's study top area was covered with this natural wood to give the sense of, you know, warmth. This glass has to withstand heavy movement, so we went for 18 mm thick laminated glass, which can take any amount of load.
So in this particular project, there's a beautiful dominance of brick texture. So we wanted to remain that as a highlighting feature. We didn't want our landscape to dominate and become wild over the period of time. And of course, maintaining those plants at different level in different balconies and open spaces also is a challenge. So we've gone for a lot of tropical varieties. Outside we have some open spaces where we work with some of these terminalias, which are tall trees. In the elevation, they'll enhance the building, you know, the whole feel of the building.
If all the users, all the three generations can come together, sit together around tables and then exchange ideas, and if the architects have the mind to understand them fully, every project can become unique.